Greetings. If you are Muslim, I invite you and even challenge you to listen to this entire video. Let's continue examining the next claim of Deedat's combat kit. Here is where the numbering diverges between the two versions of Deedat's combat kit. I'll begin using two numbers. The first number is for the first version I found, in this case, 8. The second number, 7 in parentheses, is for the second version I found. A. He that is born in thy house, and he that is bought with thy money, your slaves, must needs be circumcised, and my covenant shall be in your flesh for an everlasting covenant. Genesis 17:13. These are misspelled words in what appears to be the more authoritative copy of Deedat's combat crap. Here is the original PDF image for circumcision. You'll notice that covenant has an N in it, which I've underlined. I was a bit shocked to find it has been corrected in the simple text version of the combat kit that I initially found and used. B. The uncircumcised to be quote-unquote cut off, to be killed in parentheses. Genesis 17:14. This concept of the covenant merits a video series of its own. To keep this brief, I am going to focus on Genesis 17 in this video, not the new covenant, and not the spiritual symbolism of circumcision. Genesis 17:1. When Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, I am God Almighty. Walk before me and be blameless. I will establish my covenant between me and you, and I will multiply you exceedingly. I'm going to count usage of the word covenant and references to circumcision. This is one for covenant. Then Abram fell face down, and God said to him, As for me, this is my covenant with you. You will be the father of many nations. No longer will you be called Abram, but your name will be Abraham, for I have made you a father of many nations. That's two for covenant. These are the things Jehovah God is promising to do as his part of the covenant. I will make you exceedingly fruitful. I will make nations of you, and kings will descend from you. I will establish my covenant as an everlasting covenant between me and you and your descendants after you, to be your God and the God of your descendants after you. That's two more examples of covenant. Coming to four. And to you and your descendants I will give the land where you are residing, all the land of Canaan, as an eternal possession, and I will be their God. God also said to Abraham, You must keep my covenant, you and your descendants in the generations after you. That's five uses of covenant. This is my covenant with you and your descendants after you, which you are to keep. Every male among you must be circumcised. You are to circumcise the flesh of your foreskin, and this will be a sign of the covenant between me and you. That's two more for covenant, and the first two for circumcision, or circumcised. Circumcision is a sign of the covenant, and not the covenant itself. Generation after generation, every male must be circumcised when he is 8 days old, including those born in your household and those purchased from a foreigner, even those who are not your offspring. Whether they are born in your household or purchased, they must be circumcised. My covenant in your flesh will be an everlasting covenant. That's nine uses of covenant now, and four of circumcision. But if any male is not circumcised, he will be cut off from his people. He has broken my covenant. Covenant 10, circumcision 5. Before moving from this verse, let's address Deedat's point. B. The uncircumcised to be cut off, to be killed. Genesis 17:14. Here, Deedat exhibits the problem with Islamic thinking. it is virtually always inconsistent and ultimately wrong. Deedat asserts that to be cut off means to be killed. The uncircumcised to be cut off, quote unquote. Parenthesis, to be killed, close parenthesis. So that's Deedat's clarification. In one case for sure, we know that cut off does mean be killed. Daniel 9:26. Then after the 62 weeks, the Messiah will be cut off and will have nothing. We know cut off means be killed because of prophet Isaiah's addition. Isaiah 53:8. By oppression and judgment he was taken away, and who can recount his descendants? For he was cut off from the land of the living. He was stricken for the transgression of my people. Cut off from the land of the living is clearly referring to separation from life, meaning death. So Christians know that Messiah would die. Messiah would be killed. It is the context and the added phrase that perfectly clarifies what is meant. But Deedat, who claims to be cut off means to be killed, would never consistently and correctly apply this to Messiah's death on the cross as the prophets foretold. This is the damning danger of inconsistent Islamic thinking processes, and I use that word thinking loosely. But if any male is not circumcised, he will be cut off from his people. He has broken my covenant. Look at the ancillary phrase, from his people. This does not say from the living. Cut off means separated from his people. It means cast out, excommunicated. But understand the seed of the Islamic thinking. It is very real, and Islam can easily see to be killed. A Muslim who breaks Shahada, his oath to Allah, essentially his covenant, is to be killed, murdered by any Muslim anywhere they find them. So someone twisted by Islamic programming will see the phrase cut off and think it must obviously mean to be killed. But cut off just means a separation. The final meaning is determined by the context. It can mean death, as we saw in the case of Messiah, determined by the descriptive phrase from the land of the living. However, it does not mean killed in the verse Deedat mishandles. Then God said to Abraham, as for Sarah, your wife, do not call her Sarai, for her name is to be Sarah. And I will bless her, and will surely give you a son by her. I will bless her, and she will be the mother of nations. Kings of people will descend from her. Abraham fell face down. Then he laughed and said to himself, can a child be born to a man who is 100 years old? Can Sarah give birth at the age of 90? And Abraham said to God, oh, that Ishmael might live under your blessing. I really don't want to get wrapped around the Ishmael axle, but it is crystal clear, to Abraham at least, that God means another son will have God's covenant, and not Ishmael. That is why Abraham cries out, oh, that Ishmael might live under your blessing. And make no mistake, God was listening to Abraham, his covenant partner. And Abraham said to God, oh, that Ishmael might live under your blessing. But God replied, your wife Sarah will indeed bear you a son, and you are to name him Isaac. I will establish my covenant with him as an everlasting covenant for his descendants after him. Covenant, 12 times. Circumcision, 5 times. God reiterates, a son named Isaac would be born to Abraham and Sarah. As for Ishmael, I have heard you. Make no mistake, God was listening to Abraham, his covenant partner. God cared about what Abraham cared about. And I will surely bless him. I will make him fruitful and multiply him greatly. He will become the father of 12 rulers, and I will make him into a great nation. God promises a blessing for Ishmael, and all these good things he lists. But look again and notice there is a word you do not see. Covenant. But God was also clear and consistent and adamant about his plan regarding Isaac and Sarah and his covenant. But I will establish my covenant with Isaac, whom Sarah will bear to you at this time next year. That's 13 uses of covenant. This is the verse Muslims never read, and are never allowed to read, and consider, and understand, and believe. When he had finished speaking with Abraham, God went up from him. On that very day, Abraham took his son Ishmael and all those born in his household, or purchased with his money, every male among the members of Abraham's household, and he circumcised them, just as God had told him. That's 6 uses of circumcision. So Abraham was 99 years old when he was circumcised, and his son Ishmael was 13. Abraham and his son Ishmael were circumcised on the same day. That's 8 times circumcision, or the concept, appears. And all the men of Abraham's household, both servants born in his household and those purchased from foreigners, were circumcised with him. That's 9. He that is born in thy house, and he that is bought with thy money, your slaves, must needs be circumcised, and my covenant shall be in your flesh for an everlasting covenant. 4. As a sign, a marker, of the everlasting covenant. As long as the seed, the descendants of Isaac, continue to circumcise on the 8th day, they continue in the covenant. But I will establish my covenant with Isaac, whom Sarah will bear to you at this time next year. To this day, Muslims circumcise their male children because they think it sneaks them into the promise given to Isaac, not understanding and not regarding the very things Jehovah God said about the covenant they try and sneak themselves into. I think that covering Genesis 17 in detail gives you all the salient points necessary to refute this ignorant assertion by Deedat's combat kit. Circumcision is a sign and not the covenant itself, but it is what the Hebrews needed to do for their half of the covenant. And cut off does not mean killed in this context, even though Muslims do kill apostates by Muhammad's command. If you are Muslim, you will never hear the truth if you refuse to read the Torah as it is written, such as all of Genesis 17. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.